mudflaps and wild things. You'll never guess. We found Mr. Weenie. It's true.
Oh, no, Mr. Weenie. Mr. Weenie.
Here's the hair.
Oh, Wild Man says we need to make a pit stop for a filler. We'll see you over at the campground. Over.
Biker, biker, happy travelers.
Every year at the same time, and painfully, we have the same conversation.
We do?
Yes. Yes, we do. Is this ringing a bell?
I live, but Ada.
It'll be a long week.
Oh, Rufus, there you are. How's my shining star?
Why, Charlene, look at you. Don't you look prettier than a glob of butter on a stack of wheat cakes?
Oh, goodness me. Thank you, Rufus.
Well, I'd be much obliged.
Hey, Fifi, did you hear they found Mr. Weenie? Isn't that great?
Right.
Are you sure?
He lives with wild animals.
He's lucky they didn't hurt him.
Or kill him.
Worse, I was once in the vicious clutches of wild animals. It's too painful. Gather around. There I was, all alone. Alone in that steaming jungle, that unforgivable heart of darkness where you can't see your own paws. Roberto's back, they must all be eradicated. I'm gonna tear you apart.
I should have known better, unless you done got us all into.
Yeah, Rabbit, gambling, drinking, fighting. You're not done on Sunday. That comes on the Lord's Day. Killing crackers, well, I guess that's cool any day. But,
where we gonna spend it anyhow?
Yeah, cause there ain't no booze in hell now.
Yeah, well, boys, we've been hustling these here Cracker Barrel countries for a long time. And seeing how we've worn out our welcome, there's just one place left for us to go. I mean, three guys like us, we got to go with style.
Harlem? Harlem, we gonna elbow bend, derby twist, pee-hole pluck, ice-hole murder.
Rabbit, goddamn me, I take back everything I said about you, baby. You're still a head in here in these countries.
Yeah. Praise the Lord! Harlem.
So crazy.
Yeah.
Isn't this great, Boog?
What's great?
You know, not great that Weenie's been kidnapped, but great that we're living life on the edge. It's just like old times. Two guys out on the road.
Hey, guys. Room for one more?
For sure.
So, Elliot, now that we have a moment alone.
Oh, hey, what's that?
I've been thinking a lot about what happened at the ceremony this morning.
What do you mean?
Well, while I was saying I do, you were looking like you did it.
Wait. What do you mean? I didn't know I made anything like that.
You did it.
What? Giselle, don't be ridiculous.
Look, Elliot, I know something is bothering you. Ever since the ceremony, you've been acting a little strange. We're partners. You can tell me anything.
All right, Giselle, but remember, you asked. Basically, I'm worried about forever and ever.
Forever and ever.
About Mr. Weenie being lost forever and ever.
So, this has nothing to do with me. You're only worried about Mr. Weenie, right?
Yes, I am. But I'm mostly worried about you and me, our special day, and getting back to the ceremony. But finding Mr. Weenie could take a long, long time. Could take months, really. I mean, years, perhaps. A lifetime.